Hello everyone and welcome to the pythoninvest.com YouTube channel. Today we will look at the most popular financial APIs and see how we can visualize the obtained data. As you can see from the screen, this is a Google Colab. You need to be logged in into the Google account. You need to create a new interactive notebook through the web interface. And any Google Colab notebook is organized within a set of cells of two types. One is a text cells, so you can see an example of a text cell, and you can create a code cell or a text cell. I've created the plan for our discussion before, and let's start from Yahoo Finance. So first you need to install this model, because probably it is not available by default within this machine. You'll see that model is downloaded and installed to the runtime. Next, we try to import the new model yfinance and define an alias yf, and we also import pandas. Let's select one ticker. It will be Apple today, a company that normally has a very high volume of trade and long history. Let's try to get something from yfinance. So we got this object, and we can actually check what methods are available. You can get balance sheet, cash flow, dividends, earnings, information about the company, and many other types of useful information. Let's actually try to get institutional holders. As you can see, Vanguard owns 7.5% of Apple, and overall institutional holders represents almost 60% of holders, of owners of the stock. Let's move next to the historical information on prices. So we define a data frame, and we call our objects, and there is a methods history with the periods max. It is very convenient that within one API call you can actually got history of stock prices for 40 years. We have this information here. We can see that it is Pandas data frame object, and it has more than 10,000 entries. Let's visualize that. You can access the data frame columns through the dot notation. So let's see the close price, and we wanna visualize that with the line. It is a small graph which we might want to adjust somehow. We can define some parameters inside brackets, such as fix size and title. Much better now. But still, it's 40 years of history, and we might want to get the recent prices for this stock. Let's look at the Plotly Express library and move to the next section. If you check this address, you will have many examples of charts with Plotly Express within just two lines of code. So as you can see here, simple line is only three lines of code here. We import Plotly Express. Fortunately, we don't need to install it. And we copy code and substitute the data frame. We use df underscore apple. X is our index, date index, and Y is our close price. So we run this. We have similar picture, but now you see the exact price, and you can also work with your mouse and zoom in to the specific dates. If you double click with the left button, you will get the original graph. This is very convenient for the research purposes. Let's move next to the Pandas Datareader. So you can read through the documentation about Pandas Datareader and data providers like Stook and check all the available list of indices, but let's see how it works. We can import Pandas Datareader without installing it as well, and we will also need a datetime object to define a data range. So we want to have the prices until today for the last 40 years. So, and variable is day to day, and start variable is the same day 40 years ago. We run it and we see that it's actually working. And now let's get the data in the data frame. SPX index is a data frame. It also has more than 10,000 records with the similar columns, open, high, low, volume, and close. We can also check the data and show this with the dynamic visualization with Plotly, px.line. So it is exactly the same code, but we substitute its parameters with SPX index data frame. And we see that it was growing all 40 years, and we can zoom in to the specific period. Let's move to our last section for today. It is Quandl. It is actually a very good resource to which has more than 2,000 free and paid data sources. You will need to install this library, pip install Quandl, and to import that. You will also probably need to search for the specific data that you need. Today we will look at the gold price. It is a fresh data source which was updated just 17 hours ago. You can read that the description about gold prices, and you can see the visualization. So what we need from here, we need the Quandl code, and we copy this Quandl code to our Python call. We will also use an authorization token, which I created before with a free account on Quandl. So with the one API call, quandl.get, with this Quandl call and the same start and eight dates, we actually can see now that we downloaded the data that we want. And we, of course, can visualize that. So we want to check prices, morning prices in dollars with Plotly Express. Run the same code and we see this graph. So today you learned how to read the most popular Python financial APIs, which are Yahoo Finance, yfinance, Pandas Datareader, and Quandl. Thanks for watching and subscribe to our channel. Good luck with coding.